We're going to dissolve into our overlaid image that has been calibrated and overlaid on top of our 3D background. This particular image is the image in question of our semi-truck driving from left to right in the image, and we can see a series of illuminated lights on that vehicle. We're now going to project through to the front light and to the rear light of the vehicle in question to create a cone that is shaped between the back end of the vehicle and the front end of the vehicle. There are two red dots here now, if I go back and forth between that area, that we'll see are actually lines. Now, right now they appear as dots because they're coming directly into the center of the camera lens in question. But if I come back and replay this sequence again here, so we've got our three-dimensional model into the camera's perspective, dissolving now into the overlaid image again with the vehicle in position, we can see the rear light and the front light. And when we dissolve into that area here, we're going to see those red dots projecting through the image so that when we come up overhead of that, we can see the cone that is shaped over the area of the roadway. Now, of course, that is the measured location for those two lights. We have to keep in mind that there is a margin of error here. Before applying the margin of error, let's see where our vehicle would be if it was striking at the exact back end and the exact front end of those lights in question. So here we have another model of an object that is the same make, model, and year of vehicle as the known vehicle in question at the same size. And we can see here that our light is being intersected here on the front and the rear end of the vehicle. So it's measured to be directly in the center lane. But let's apply our margin of error now to see all of the areas that that vehicle can be in.